In one of the largest game jams, the GMTK Game Jam, developers have been steadily moving away from traditional engines like Unity and using an open source alternative, Godot. In 2020, only a small percentage of games used Godot, but by 2024, the number has more than tripled. Some might argue it's due to the Unity's runtime fee controversy, and that's partially true. Godot gained significant attention after that, but it also has a lot to offer, from its beginner-friendly scripting language to its node-based architecture. So in this episode, let's take a quick look at the Godot engine. Godot's journey started way back in 2001, created by two guys from Argentina, Juan Linsky and Ariel Manzur. It was originally just a tool used internally by studios like Occam Studio. Its name was inspired by the play Waiting for Godot, reflecting the creator's long-term vision for a complete and evolving game engine. After years of private use, they made it open source in 2014, and that's when things really took off. In 2018, Godot 3.0 dropped with a shiny new rendering engine and VR support, and updates like 3.1 and 4.0 brought some serious improvements like better mobile performance and way faster JD script. Fast forward to today, and Godot is a pretty big deal. It has matured with the creation of W4 games to handle commercial features like console exports and the formation of the Godot Foundation in 2022 to oversee its future development. It is recognized as a powerful and accessible engine for both 2D and 3D game development. Plus, it's open source, which is a huge win for people who want to avoid paying royalties or revenue cuts like Unity or Unreal. Godot works on all major platforms, including Android, and there's even a web editor if you don't want to download anything. When you first get started, there are two versions of Godot to pick from. The standard one, which uses GD script, and the .NET version for C# users. I really like how flexible it is right from the get-go. You can choose the version based on the language you want to use. Oh, and it's super lightweight. Only a few megabytes compared to the gigabytes other engines take up. Once you open it up, you can hit the create button to start making your game from scratch. Or you can grab some community-made templates from the asset library. There are tons of them, like the Max menu template, which gives you pre-built menus and a scene loader. And the best part? These templates are free to use. What I love most about Godot is the node-based scene system. Basically, everything in Godot is a node. A sprite, a sound, a camera, a button, even things like timers and animations. You can then combine these nodes into scenes, which makes it super easy to structure your game, debug it, and extend it as you go. It's such a clean way to work. Now, if you're a beginner or switching from another engine, you will love how easy GD script is to learn. It's super similar to Python. You indent code instead of using curly braces. But if GD script isn't your thing, you can always use C# or even use both. Want to use C or C++? There's a support for that too through GD extensions. Godot 4 has made significant strides in 3D graphics performance, narrowing the gap between itself and industry giants like Unity and Unreal Engine. This improvement is largely due to the introduction of new Vulkan-based renderer, which enhances visual fidelity and optimizes performance across various hardware configurations. When compared to Unity and Unreal Engine, Godot 4 offers a compelling alternative, especially for indie developers and small studios. Its open source nature and lighter system requirements make it an attractive option for developers seeking flexibility and efficiency. For me, I started with Unreal, but it was just too slow and laggy. So, I switched to Godot, and it's been way faster and much lighter in size. Some cool games made with Godot include Brotato, Ocean Mirror, and Dome Keeper.